Hello, biology fans. Today we're going to do a short tutorial on ploidy and what that means. And if you look up the definition of ploidy, there are so many different definitions, you might get a little lost in what people are saying. So let's start with an example. Let's start with humans. We know that humans are 2N, and we are diploid. Diploid. So what does diploid mean? Diploid refers to the fact that we have two of each different chromosome. Right? You get one from mom, you get one from dad, and together, how many total chromosomes do humans have? The total number of chromosomes equals 46. All right, so we are diploid. We have two of each different chromosome. So we have a pair. If you're an organism that happens to be triploid, right? Triploid. That means you are 3N. You have three of every single chromosome. And let's say you're an organism, I don't know, that has just a total of 12 chromosomes. So if 3N equals 12, that means that this is a very simple math equation, divide 3 on each side, so N equals 4. Those are 4 different chromosomes. Okay, I like to just say that means you have chromosome number 1, chromosome number 2, chromosome number 3, and chromosome number 4. 4 different chromosomes. And if I use red as my little chromosome, if this is a chromosome that I draw, right? How many? You have three of each of those. So you would have three of number 1, three of number 2, three of number 3, right? And three of number 4. If you add those together, 3 plus 3 plus 3 plus 3, you get 12 total chromosomes. And you are triploid, meaning you have three of each. All right, you may be thinking this is a little juvenile, all right, but let's just do one more. Okay, so if you are 4N, you are tetraploid. Meaning you have four of each individual chromosome. So let's have another example. If you have a total of 20 chromosomes, that means 4N equals 20. If you solve for N, N equals 5. N is the number of distinct or different chromosomes. So you have chromosome number 1, chromosome number 2, chromosome number 3, chromosome number 4, chromosome number 5, and right now you would have how many copies of each? 4 of each. I don't know if you can really see that yellow color. How about we try green? Okay, if you total up the total number of chromosomes there, you see that you have a total of 20, and you have 4 of the same chromosomes. Okay, this turns out to be a real problem for students. I hope this little tutorial helps you. And good luck with your genetics.